So I wanted to make a video today, but I might have deleted the script for it, and that is a big problem, because I didn't really think it was the best video, but now I'm looking back and I'm thinking, that's actually a really good video idea, let's do it. And, yeah, I might not have the script anymore for it. If I do have the script, I guess you'll see what the video is about, but if I don't, well then, it's gonna suck. Quick disclaimer, when I'm making this video, I'm making the assumption you already have a chair, desk, and a computer to work with. What's up guys, Nick here, and today I'm gonna be talking about the best YouTube setup for under $600. Now, when I kinda had made this setup, I was using a bunch of old stuff that I had laying around, like my old Blue Snowball Ice that I really don't use that much. I kinda just use it for like for my PlayStation stuff. Using the classic, you know, the light I always use, my onboard camera light, my little three-legged tripod, all that type of stuff. Just kinda build this general setup. So the parts I use will be linked in the description below. Basically, I'm using a Joby GorillaPod 5K, I feel like that's a good size. I'm using the Blue Snowball Ice, which is actually a great microphone. It's like 50 bucks. Gives you great audio quality. I'm actually using it right now and I sync the audio in post. Basically, I always clap my hands so I have some reference points to work with in post when I'm trying to sync the audio up. And then that's on a classic mic arm because, you know, it does the job perfectly. And it just kind of gives you a little bit more flexibility than the standard little tripod kit they kind of include with it. For the camera, I have the Canon SX60HS. And for the light, obviously, I'm using an onboard camera light. I'll link one down below that I found because I couldn't find this exact one anymore. All right, onto the iPhone footage so you can see exactly what we're working with here.
All right, this is the setup. We got microphone on the mic arm. That is because, as I said, great microphone. I actually used to use this mic arm right here. I'd clamp it down like right here. Have my chair kind of set up how it was. But I'd actually screw this mic onto it because this fits perfectly. And as you can see, it's plugged in my laptop so I can sync the audio and post. Got my script up here. Then right here is the main camera. As you guys know, this is the Canon SX60HS. Very familiar with it on the channel. I've used it for like almost 2 years now, actually. It's a great camera, you can't go wrong with this. $350 refurbished, definitely a great deal. They have the $37-ish onboard camera light, which does the job, absolutely incredible. This one has a little gel on so it can get nice and warm, so it's really natural and looks the best. And this is actually an off-brand Joby GorillaPod, but I definitely recommend you get the actual one because this one right here, very unstable, it falls apart, it's flimsy, it's just not the best. Granted, I've had it for about a year and it's done the job. But definitely, if you're going out for something like this, get an actual Joby one that comes with the ball head so you can kind of get all the maneuvers with it and stuff.
And audio is absolutely key. If you do not have good audio, your video is going to suffer. Audio is the one thing you should be concerned with, other than content, obviously. But next to content, audio is the most important. Next up is lighting. So using something simple like a light like this, just to light you, just so you know that you are the main subject of the shot. And if this chair wasn't so like thick back here, you'd actually see I have a couple Christmas lights back there, kind of add for mood lighting. And if you're filming like something like against the desk, like I usually do, I actually want to put the Christmas lights on my desk when I actually move back over to my regular little set. So that way I kind of have a little extra light in the background so you can see the room isn't kind of as dark. What I could do is, hold on.
I could kind of turn on this lamp back here. Gotta plug it in first.
What I'm saying is lighting is also key so you know what the subject is of the shot. Like, I'm well lit so you can tell that I am the subject. And heck, maybe even darkening your background like this could kind of point the eyes even more towards you so you're not trying to look at something that's nice and bright in the background. That lamp back there, something nice and subtle and small, but it's not dominating the background. Always have your main light pointing to your subject and not behind them. Now you're shooting a goal now, you're trying to get some nice cinematic lens flares, by all means, shoot towards the sun, but if you're doing a studio setup like this, the brightest light should be facing me. Kind of have some more dim lights in the background, kind of add a little bit of life to it. And now when you're buying gear, you shouldn't only look at the specs. As I talked about last video, when buying a camera, don't only look at the resolution, because there's so much more that goes into it, like codecs and things like that. And just like anything, don't only look at the specs, look up videos of real world tests to see if it's something that you'd want. Like this camera here, I was debating between this one or the Canon S120, because that camera is a nice small point and shoot, and I've seen a couple YouTubers use it, and it's a great camera, gives them great video quality, it has pretty decent built-in audio. But I kind of thought, you know, I should look elsewhere, and I saw the Canon SX60HS, how cheap it was, and I'm like, wow, what's wrong with it? There's something, why is it so cheap? So I looked up some video tests, things like that online about how this camera performs, and it performed absolutely amazing in the videos. So I saw a real world test with this camera, I'm like, that is a very good camera. I'll take that one for Christmas if you wouldn't mind, parents. All right, let's talk a little bit about software as I wrap up the video here. Your software, the only requirement you really need for it is that it can sync audio. If you can't sync audio files, the setup really won't work for you. Then I definitely recommend going with the mic arm, but also getting something like this so you can plug it right in your camera and it syncs for you. This is a little bit more expensive, but it does give you some really nice clean audio results. And as I said, it really saves you work in post because it's all synced within the camera. And you don't need fairly fancy high-tech software. Like, you know, I'm literally using iMovie to edit this video just to show that it can be done. That's it for me, guys. Thank you all for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video.
Hey, sorry I'm back for like 2 seconds. I'm looking at a new laptop. Well, in case you guys don't know, I've had a job since like May.
It's not terrible, not the end of the world, not the worst thing I've ever done, but I've been working to save up for a new laptop. So, the laptop I'm looking at is this one right here. It's a 2013 15-inch MacBook Pro. It cost $3,000 when it was released, so it's freaking crazy. It has a quad-core i7, 2.6 gigahertz, you can turbo boost it up to 3.8, I believe. Has an NVIDIA GeForce GT750M graphics card with 2 gigabytes of video memory paired with Intel Iron 5200 graphics with 1 gigabyte of video memory. Now, why are there two, you might ask? That's because when they designed it, the integrated graphics are for when you're on battery power, you're not doing really anything intensive, so it's for power saving. Then when you fire off something like a game or like Final Cut or any editing software for that matter, the dedicated graphics card will kick in to give you that maximum performance. Continuing on, it has 16 gigabytes of DDR3 1600 megahertz RAM. Now, obviously the RAM's a little old, but basically the same components were used from 2013 to 2015, except for some slight graphics card changes in the 2015 model. It has 512 gigabyte PCIe based SSD storage, so that's super fast storage, and so I have half a gigabyte of storage on my laptop, so that's pretty good. Plus I have my external 1 terabyte storage for video backups and things like that. But yeah, this laptop will cost me about $1,500, and I should have it here within about 2 weeks if I did my math calculations correctly, because I'm starting to work longer hours now that Christmas time's around. So yeah, just thought I could update you guys on that. This laptop is an absolute beast. I am so excited for it, but this is the actual end. Peace out.